Welcome, Class of 2020, to the Senior Awards Ceremony. Despite the fact that we can't be together at this time, we still want to recognize and honor you each for your hard work. Various awards will be recognized tonight, including academic achievement, awards given out by each department, and scholarship winners will be announced. We are very proud of all of your achievements.
Hi, Class of 2020. This is Mrs. LaPerry, school counselor. I just wanted to say congratulations to the entire graduating class, and I'd like to take this opportunity to recognize the valedictorians of the Class of 2020. A valedictorian is a student with a cumulative GPA of 4.0 or higher. We have 27 valedictorians in this graduating class, so we congratulate you on that sustained level of academic achievement throughout your 4 years in high school. You have many opportunities before you, and we encourage you to fearlessly pursue your dreams and ambitions. Valedictorians are recognized through the graduation ceremonies by the wearing of the gold cap and gown, as well as a valedictorian's medal. So congratulations to all of you and the entire class. Please take a moment to watch this short slideshow honoring our valedictorians and the meritorious valedictorian. Congratulations.
TV, sunset done change ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. They was never friendly. Yeah. Now I'm jumping out the Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you with winning, put your lighters to the sky. How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with that booty, I just put it to the side. Bought a sense of baby, they could see it in my eyes. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done change ever since we was on. I dreamed it all.
This year, Rosamond High is offering the President's Award for Educational Excellence for the first time. This award recognizes academic success in the classroom. To be eligible, students must have an overall GPA of 3.5 or higher and a teacher or staff recommendation stating that the student has excelled in an academic area. Congratulations to the following students for receiving the President's Award for Educational Excellence. We are also proud of you and your academic achievements.
Now everywhere I go, they say congratulations. Young graduation. Yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Number old Ben Franklin. Cash. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Paso big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught up.
Hey, this is Coach Wallace with Roseland Baseball. Coming to present an award, a very special award, for one of our senior baseball players. And this is in honor of our son, Brett Wallace, who played here at Rosamond High School for 4 years, a varsity starter, played in college baseball. And in fact, the room here I'm in has pictures of him and a lot of his jerseys and just things that we remember from him. He's very special in our lives, and we miss him. He passed away, but we have been given this award every year in his name, in his honor, to an outstanding senior that's done a great job at Rosamond High School in sports and academics and just all around. So this year, we want to honor one of our seniors, and that is Tommy Appleby. Tommy has been a varsity player for 3 years. And Tommy, we're so sorry that your senior year got cut short. We know you are going to have a great season. Tommy was one of our top players for the last 3 years, and one of our top pitcher last year. Great player, great person, and this year a great leader. So we're pleased to announce that Tommy Appleby is the winner of the Brett Wallace Award for outstanding performance on the field and off the field. And we wish you the best, Tommy, and hope that you have the opportunity to play some baseball again. So thank you again, and good luck to you in the future. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Miss Greenberg, and I'm here presenting tonight for RTA. RTA stands for Rosamond Teachers Association. RTA had a total of $5,000 to give away, and so it is my pleasure to give to some very deserving students. So, Alana Finch, congratulations. Braden Parker, also congratulations. Victoria Gomez and Aaliyah Valenzuela. All four of these students have worked very hard to get where they are, and RTA looks forward to them having a bright future ahead of them.
Good evening. Healthy minds, fit bodies, and a strong community. We believe in order to obtain these qualities, you must be dedicated, hardworking, fearless enough to face life's challenges, and brave enough to chase your dreams. You have to have ambition. Rosamond Fitness is proud and humbled to recognize two lucky seniors this year on the class of 2020, and we present the Rosamond Health and Fitness Ambition Scholarships this year to Braden Parker and Tori Gomez. Congratulations, guys.
Hi, I'm Miss Greenberg, and I'm also presenting for the Rosamond High School Staff Scholarship. And I'd like to present that award to Eduardo Gonzalez. Eduardo, congratulations. I'm sure you have a bright future ahead of you.
Hello, class of 2020. I'm here for the English Awards. This is very different. Sending a taped segment in for a video to be made for you is very different than greeting you and your parents in the gym and watching my colleagues give awards and students being clapped for one by one. But this is where we are this year, 2020. And so I always try to wrap my awards in a bit of context, and I've been looking at Ralph Waldo Emerson, one of my favorite poets who lived in the 1800s, about 200 years ago. He had a lot of really good friends. Among them was Henry David Thoreau and Louisa May Alcott. Maybe you know them, maybe you don't. But Ralph Waldo Emerson is responsible for quite a bit as far as American writing goes. And he said a couple of things that we hear all of the time and we don't realize it's Ralph Waldo Emerson who said them. He said, one of the things that you've probably heard before, life is a journey, not a destination. So that goes back to one of the old guys that wrote poetry 200 years ago. And then the other thing that he said that I think we might be able to take to heart is the only person you are destined to become is the person you decide to become. And I've watched you this year, class of 2020, in your writing and in your responses and in the conversations that we've had, the person that you are deciding to become and how you're defying destiny in one way or the other. I would really love to have awards for every single one of my students, and every year they tell me I can't do that because it would take too long. Someone's probably looking at their watch right now saying, oh my goodness, when is she going to get to the awards? Well, I'm going to get to them right now. They limited me to 3 students out of 100 and I don't know how many that I need to give awards to. So I have tried to narrow it down as best I could and hope to postpone disappointment and feel really terrible that I can't name every single name on my roster. So the first award goes for the President's Education Award in English, and that is being awarded to Kayla Pareto because he has shown an ability to work beyond his ability. He has shown a stamina and an endurance and in all of the academic endeavors that I have seen him attack this year with enthusiasm and grace and humility and honesty and very brave and courageous about the things that he has done this year in my class. So that President's Education Award goes to Kayla Pareto. Hopefully everyone is clapping, yay! All right, and so for Outstanding Academic Achievement in English, my first award goes to Montana Gear for the brilliant, beautiful words and the ability to not quit until a piece is finished. And so she always shows that the writing can always be revised. Writing takes to heart the fact that writing is never finished, never turns in something half done or mediocre, always with revision in mind, always with the best chosen words possible, and is a kind of a reading maniac as well. And so keeping up that A average in English all year and putting forth her best effort all the time, Montana Gear for Outstanding Academic Achievement. And the last award for Outstanding Academic Achievement in English goes to Mr. Tate Bird, who is one of the most brilliant writers I have read in a long time. I wish that I could write like him. I wish that his words were mine when I go to put words on the page, and I hope that he seeks to publish his memoir someday, because I think it's worth publication, it's worth an audience, and his voice really should be heard. And so those are the awards for the English department. Remember, you guys, it's not the destination, it's the journey. I will see you soon.
My name is Mr. Riley, and I'm here to give away two awards. But before I say their names, this has been one of the hardest things I've ever had to do, because there's so many of you out there that deserves awards for your improvement and how well you're doing in my classes. But I can only give away two, so here we go. The first one goes to Destiny Vieira for the most outstanding and improved student in Auto Shop, and the second one goes to Miss Winter Valentine, who went way beyond any expectations I ever had. So congratulations. Riley says good congratulations. Everybody be safe and have fun out there.
Good evening. My name is Mrs. Tanksley, and I teach government and economics. It is with great joy that I present to two of my students the Outstanding Academic Achievement Award. Both students have shown a resilient spirit, kindness, compassion, tolerance in the classroom on a daily basis. They are deep thinkers. They hold firm to what they believe in and stand by their personal convictions. And I'm so incredibly proud to be their teacher. So, with the deepest love, respect, and admiration, I proudly present to Haven Stone and Oscar Castanon the Outstanding Academic Achievement Award. Thank you so much.
For art, I would like to give the President's Educational Achievement Award to James Branford for demonstrating commitment to learning and academics despite various obstacles. And for him, his obstacle was that he had a traumatic brain injury, which impacted his whole life, but he still creates amazing artwork, and he participated in our art show in both the Rosamond School Library and the Rosamond Public Library. So he did an awesome job, and he's an amazing artist.
Hello, everyone. Tonight, I would like to present the President's Award from the Math Department to Corinne Braden. And Corinne has been a top student for the past 4 years, and she maintains one of the highest GPA among the seniors. She is also highly self-motivated, talented, and she always works really hard to achieve her goals. And she's going to UCLA to pursue her dreams. So congratulations, Corinne. And next, I would like to present the Outstanding Academic Achievement Award to Eduardo Gonzalez. And he is going to graduate 1 year early. And he's ranked number one among the 183 seniors. He has taken multiple college classes from ABC, and especially math classes. And he got straight A's in all his high school classes, especially his high school math and college math classes. And he has the highest SAT score among all the seniors this year. So congratulations. Last, I would like to present the Most Improved Student Award to Daniel Montano. Daniel was first in my regular geometry class. Then I sent him to Honors Algebra 2 when he was a sophomore because I could see his talent and I could see he worked really, really hard. And he took a good number of college math classes from ABC, including calculus. And he did well in all those math classes. And he did go above and beyond what I could imagine. So congratulations, Daniel. And at last, congratulations to Corinne, Eduardo, and Daniel. Your hard work are being recognized today, and your hard work will be rewarded in your future. We need more students to go to the STEM field, and I'm glad they make a really good choice for their future. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. The science department would like to honor three wonderful Rosamond High School seniors. First, this senior has worked hard her entire educational career and has proven to have the dedication, maturity, and skills to go above and beyond in science. Lauren Butler, congratulations on earning the President's Award for Educational Achievement. We'd also like to honor two other amazing seniors who have worked incredibly hard and shown that they have what it takes to achieve greatness in science. The Science Awards for Outstanding Academic Achievement go to Eduardo Gonzalez and Starniza Willis. Congratulations.
Hello, class of 2020. I'm here to announce the awards for ASB. The first award I'd like to announce and talk about is the Presidential Award for ASB. I chose this person because every single year that I have been an advisor, not only for the class of 2020, but for ASB, she has been willing and participating in everything that we've done. She's a willing participant. She's done every fundraiser. She has the school with the best of interest for the school. And she's an all-around great kid. Her name is Jocelyn Boyle. The next award I'd like to announce is for Strongest Leadership. This one came with a hard choice, but I took the one leader that I know is the best, and she's been great in her position ever since she's held it. She's held it for the last 2 years. She did a lot for the class of 2020. And when she was a junior, she did a lot for them in preparing for her prom, any class fundraisers we had, and she was more than willing to lead in all and direct all meetings. The Strongest Leadership Award goes to Victoria Gomez. The next award I have is for School Spirit. This person, she took the position of being Commissioner of Spirit this year. This is a position that we have not had for a few years, and she took it knowingly that she had to boost school spirit, come up with some great pep rallies, and get everyone involved. The award for school spirit goes to Gwen Playtest. Thank you all and have a good night.
Well, it isn't quite the same giving out these awards in my living room, but I am very excited to be able to honor some of our theater students. It's been a weird year, and as we all know, and these students have been so resilient. We started the year with one of our shows getting postponed, and then we had to wait all of Thanksgiving break to be able to do the show again. And every time these students were just there, smile on their face, even when it was tough, and we got to still put on some great theater this year. And I'm so grateful for the time I've gotten to spend with these specific students over the past few years, and for just the work and the effort and the love and the passion that they've poured into our program. So our Presidential Education Award for our theater department is going to go to Hans Hodges. And we have two outstanding theater students. Those are Dawn Cooper and Athena Hernandez. All three of them have given their whole hearts, their time, their effort, their care to our theater program, and I'm going to miss them dearly, and I'm grateful for all that they've done.
Hello, everybody. It's Mr. Hansen. I'm here to give out the awards for yearbook. So that being said, I want to get started. For the President's Education Award from the yearbook department, I wanted to give it to an individual who has been kind of the yearbook's secret weapon. She works behind the scenes all the time. She rarely speaks up, but because of that, she's constantly working and working hard to make sure our yearbook is the way it is. So without further ado, I wanted to present the President's Education Award to Starneza Willis. She has always been known as our secret weapon. She rarely has any issues with what is planned, but also allows us to know when there is one. She works through her crazy schedule. She always lets me know when things were needing extra help, but usually they weren't because she's the one who took care of them. I really want to express my appreciation and thankfulness for Starneza being on the staff this year. She really deserves this award, and the yearbook, like I said, would not be the way it is without her. That being said, the second award goes to, it's an award for outstanding leadership. And that award, I think, can go none other than to our own Elizabeth Guzman. She was the editor-in-chief this year, or a co-editor-in-chief at least, but she's our only senior that's an editor. And she led us through this whole year. She was never afraid to speak her mind when necessary. She showed to me what true leadership is, which is she did not take control. She allowed others to do what they needed to do and then chimed in whenever necessary. She made her priority the yearbook staff and not herself, which is rare in an individual and I think shows true leadership. And when she needed to be harsh and stern with what the things that needed to be done and deadlines we needed to meet, she also met that goal too. And beyond all that, she's a human being that is just lovely, that we'd love to have in class. And she's the one and only yearbooker I've had all 3 years of my career here at RHS so far. And I wanted to make a special shout out to her for that because she's awesome. And I appreciate her leadership and just her in general and the yearbook staff for the last 3 years. So thank you, Elizabeth. And lastly, one last award for tremendous effort. And I don't want that to be taken lightly, right? The yearbook, though is just a bound book, is more than just that. There's a lot that goes on behind the scenes, fundraising, photographs, going to all the events, constantly working late, picking up the slack of everyone else sometimes, trying out new ideas and working hours on end with maybe us ultimately scrapping the idea. And there's one individual for sure that stands out. And that individual is Alicia Move. I believe I pronounced her last name correctly. I apologize if I didn't. Alicia has helped me out for this whole year and then half of last year in yearbook. She's constantly shown effort. She constantly wants to help with everything. She sometimes even goes above and beyond what her actual assignment is and helps other people out. She always went to as many events as she possibly could. And she deserves to be recognized. Alicia has helped the yearbook staff so much this last year. Similar to with everyone else on the staff, I don't want to neglect all the other staff members, but these three individuals today stood out to me as showing an exceeding job, amazing leadership, and tremendous effort, especially by Alicia. So thank you all three of you, and all 13 of you that are in the yearbook staff currently, and all those that were part of the yearbook this year. I think that's it for me, so I'll leave it to the next person, but thank you all, and I really appreciate the three of you.
Hello, this is Captain Wallace, California Cadet Corps, Rosamond High School, here to present awards to some of our outstanding senior cadets, and we have many outstanding seniors in our program that deserve awards. Today, we will be focusing on three awards. Many of our seniors were part of an outstanding ROTC program led by Major Tanksley, Master Sergeant Taylor, and others. And they have been integral in transitioning from Air Force JROTC to California Cadet Corps, demonstrating the Cadet Corps motto, Esse Ons, which means let us try. Our first award is the Lance Corporal Joseph C. Lopez Pratty Award, given by the Pratty family. Joey Pratty attended Rosamond Schools and gave his life for our country, serving with the 3-5 Marines on October 14, 2010 in Afghanistan. This award is given to someone who demonstrates courage in overcoming adversity and serving as a cadet and as a leader. Just as Joey had to overcome personal obstacles and setbacks, this cadet has demonstrated the same perseverance and courage. This cadet was also a member of Air Force ROTC. The 2020 Lance Corporal Joseph C. Lopez Pratty Award goes to Cadet Command Sergeant Major Robert Carter Cade. Our second award is the President's Award for Educational Achievement, given for outstanding educational growth, improvement, and commitment. To a student who has demonstrated a high level of success, both as a student and leader, also overcoming personal challenges along the way. This cadet has also been part of the ROTC program, part of multiple sports teams, ASB, and a strong leader for Cadet Corps. The 2020 California Cadet Corps President's Award for Educational Achievement goes to Cadet Staff Sergeant Ashton Soder. Our third award is given to our top cadet leader. This award goes to a leader who has demonstrated strong and compassionate leadership, commitment, and caring for others. This cadet excels in the classroom and in leading cadets. This cadet is a model student, an example for others to follow. Another exceptional ROTC leader throughout the year, demonstrating motivation and commitment to bring Cadet Corps to a high level of success, stepping up to do the hard work of leading others to overcome many challenges. Our final award is given to our battalion commander, Cadet Captain Lily Shaw. Congratulations to you and to all the seniors, and we wish you the best. We miss all of you. Thank you so much for being part of Cadet Corps and making it and helping it become a great program. We wish you the best, and remember, Esse Ons, let us try.
So it's senior awards time. This year I get to pass out three. Certainly is not enough, but you know, rules. And you know, if you're in the bulletin class, you know it takes more than just three people. It takes an entire class to put together something worth watching, but I'm able to give three to three deserving students, so I'm excited to do so. So we'll pretend for a little bit. Just pretend we're there, and I'll call this person up. They'll get their award, they'll go have a seat, and yeah, we'll get through this. Shoot, my quarantine haircut's getting out of control. Anyway, our first award goes to a very special person. They've been with me for 2 years, and that's kind of part of the requirement every year, because I got to break it down somehow, you know. 2 years, and this person, man, really hit the ground running last year when I met them, and this year just stepped it up, and was really one of the main reasons why we had a bulletin so often. And this person would email me on quarantine saying, hey, what do you need? What can I do? It's awesome. I totally appreciate it. And that person is, drumroll, editor of the year. Fix the hair. Alexander Rivas, come on up. Awesome job, awesome job. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right, grab a seat. All right, man. Good job, good job. Yeah, he's a great student. The next award, it's producer of the year. This person, again, been with me 2 years. And man, I think in a 2 year stretch, this person's been in the most, has just been a part of the most content, whether it's writing, editing, shooting, acting, it doesn't matter. Like, this person has been a part of almost every story over the last 2 years. And man, this person is one of the reasons why we've had pretty funny bulletins, because this person's hilarious. And that would be for Nina. Christina Esparza, come on up. Good job, good job. Thank you so much. You really deserve it. All right. Thank you. Anyway, she's awesome. She did a lot of work. And the final award, the Big Daddy, President's Education Award, goes to another student that's been with me for 2 years. She almost didn't take the class, but she ended up taking it and really changed the whole program. She has written, edited, acted, done everything almost every week, even at home, and has done such a fabulous job. And she's going to do this for a career. She's been accepted in a college program to be doing digital media stuff, and that is L-Dog, Lydia Rhea. Come on up. Good job, L-Dog. And just want to say thank you so much, because this year has just been so awesome. You really took a leadership role. Thank you so much. Good job. Good job. All right. That does it for the awards. I think I'm the last one. So congratulations to everybody who got an award. And to the class of 2020, congratulations. And good luck with your future. All right. Take care. Bye.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We are also proud of your achievements and your perseverance through this unprecedented time. We can't wait to hear about all the things that you're going to accomplish in the future. Good luck.